Nokomis Warrior Broadcasting presents Nokomis Varsity Basketball. Tonight, the Coney Rams take on our Nokomis Warriors. Tape live January 8th, 2024 from Newport, Maine at Nokomis Regional High. And bring you tonight's game, Hallie and Mia Coots.
Thank you, Mr. Brown, for the intro. So we are pretty excited to be doing this game tonight. First game of 2024 for us. I think for the whole program, right, Mr. Brown?
Yes. Yes.
Yeah, pretty exciting. You know, I definitely had a little bit of a moment when he said 2024. I wasn't ready for that. You know, I think that we're going to have a pretty good matchup here tonight. Our Warriors have been getting a lot better throughout the season. They're putting the work in, and you can see that they're getting closer and just doing a better job on the court, I think. What do you, Hal?
Absolutely. Their team bond has gotten much better, and they're really working together. Those team dinners are really working on their bond, and they're really working together and getting better on the court, and it shows.
Yeah, absolutely. Do you have the heel points there that you can read off for us?
I do. So Camden Hills is in first place with 5 wins and 4 losses. Lawrence, 7 wins and 0 losses. And Coney, they have 4 wins and 3 losses. And our Nokomis Warriors are in 9th place, 1 win and 7 losses.
Yeah, gotcha. You know, heel points have always confused me a little bit, being an athlete myself. They always seem to work themselves out at the end of the year, but it does seem a little backwards to have first place someone at 5-4 and second place someone at 7-0. But what can you do? I mean,
I know they're a little confusing in that way. You see 7 wins and no losses, and then you look at first place with 5 wins and 4 losses, and you're like, what's going on here?
Yeah, definitely. You know, earlier today I spoke with some of the girls on our Warriors basketball team, and they were telling me that they think that it's been a really good year of development for them, and that throughout the beginning of the season to now, they've grown a lot, and that they can compete with anyone at this point. They might not win any of the rest of their games, but they're going to be able to compete way more than they were able to before.
Yes, I definitely totally agree with you.
Good evening and welcome to Nokomis Regional High for today's regular season matchup between the visiting Rams of Coney High School and your Nokomis Warriors. We hope you enjoy today's game and support these athletes, coaches, and officials in a positive manner. Now let's meet the starting lineups first for the Rams. A senior, number 1, Morgan Cunningham. A senior, number 4, Macy Freeman. A junior, number 13, Abby Morrill. A senior, number 14, Kale Barajas. And a junior, number 21, Morgan Fickthorn. The managers are Ashley Olson and Abby Brown. The Rams are coached by John Dennett and assisted by Shea Freeman. And now make some noise for your Nokomis Warriors. A senior, number 11, Emberly Mishud. A junior, number 12, Danica Migliori. A sophomore, number 20, Reagan King. A sophomore, number 34, Briley Bollier. And a junior, number 44, Addison Hawthorne. The managers are Lauren Russell and Raylan Poulin. The Warriors are coached by Kyle Peavy and assisted by Adam King, Kate Rush, and April McAlpine. The officials for tonight's game are Brian Clark and Jill St. Peter. At this time, would you all please rise and join us in honoring America with the singing of our national anthem by Elena Donahue, and the presentation of colors by the Nokomis JROTC Color Guard. As is customary with the Color Guard, please remain standing until they have exited the gymnasium.
but so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the rampart we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Color guard, halt. Order colors. Fall out.
All right, and we are about ready to start here tonight. I love watching the color guard. I think it's just the coolest thing. We have an awesome JROTC program, one of the best in the state. We're definitely the biggest in the state, I think. They go to these conferences throughout the year and have really an awesome time. So it's so awesome to be able to see them getting out and doing things at other Nokomis events as well.
Yeah, it's really awesome to see all of the Nokomis Warriors really all in one. You can see the cheerleaders. You see Elena Donahue. She normally always does.
The anthem,
thank you. My goodness, just went blank. Chose does a nice job, and then the color guard normally comes in and does it, and it's just really awesome to see our community.
Awesome, and the Warriors get the tip-off here early tonight. Sorry to interrupt you, but
I'll take it. It's fine.
That's right. Reagan King with an early shot, and it dribbles in. Love to see Nokomis. Oh, they called that a three. I thought she was within the three-point line, but awesome. I love seeing the Warriors start off early with a three there. And Coney goes to match it, and it does not fall. Another three shot by Coney, and that one is drained.
Early three-pointers in the game, both being made, though. So we have a tie, 3-3, or now 5-3, Coney.
Yeah, Coney putting the press on early. Not surprised at all. They're a very aggressive team. And, you know, just like I was talking about there, the aggression coming up on Danica Migliore there and just shaking the ball away from her does end up being a Nokomis inbound, though. Michaud finds King. Coney is really quick. They don't really let Nokomis get any easy possession. They're going to have to work for everything they get. Reagan puts up a tough shot with mid-range, and it falls. So we have a tie ball game, 5-5. Three shot does not fall. Great defense being played by the Warriors early here. And Coney with a turnover.
You know, Mia, what I've noticed is that the Coney team is pretty old. A lot of seniors and juniors, no really underclassmen.
Old? What do you mean by that? You calling me old?
No, I'm calling the Coney Rams. Old.
Yeah, but I'm a senior, huh?
Okay. Not everything's about you here.
Hey, I'm just saying, we could have used a different adjective other than old,
all
for
right.
The record.
Many upperclassmen, is that better?
Yes, that's a great appreciate that. Coney goes in for a two there. But yeah, you're absolutely right. They do have a much older squad. They're looking at a lot of leadership on the court and very athletic looking girls for sure. Yeah. Mishoud for a two mid-range and it falls. You know, when we were watching warm-ups, the Warriors looked like they could not miss a shot. And we spoke to the manager prior to the game, and she said that the girls were all in a great mood and they were super positive heading into this game and were just looking forward to having fun playing with each other. And that type of positivity breeds good things on the court.
Absolutely.
We're looking at the Warriors being super aggressive early, too. Long three there, shot, and it does not fall. Heads out to the same girl, and that one is short this time. A really tough contested two goes up, and after about three shots in the paint, a foul is called on one of the Warriors, and so number 14 will go to the line for shots. And the first one is short, off the front of the rim. I think a really underrated part of basketball is the free throws. They always come back to bite, and people don't necessarily recognize that until it's late in the game. But it's early in the game, too, when you really count it up. If you have one person heading to the line a lot and they don't make their free throws, that is going to come back to bite you later on in the game, at any point in the game, really.
Definitely.
Danny Migliori for a three, and it is wide, and so goes off the backboard into the hands of Coney. We know that the Warriors are a little bit of an undersized team, but they are still pretty athletic. But this Coney team is very athletic. You see those girls on the court. They're moving with every play, and the Warriors just really can't get a defensive rebound. Reagan King for three, and that is good.
She's doing pretty good tonight, both three-pointers here in the game. And she has, so far, she has, how many points here, Mia? She has eight, I'm pretty sure.
Yes, that is the correct math. Right,
math.
Nice job.
Yep. We're going.
It's all right. Where's the calculator? We don't need to do that in our heads. It's so Warriors on the inbound here.
Yes, if we want to stay competitive in this game, we as in Nokomis Warriors, then we really need to box out, get a body on them. You see, you know, it's going to be a tough game. And to try to stay competitive and close in this game, they really need to box out, get the rebound, and then keep control of the ball.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, we've seen already how aggressive Coney is playing, and we've seen Nokomis match that, which is something that we're not used to necessarily seeing from them. They play a little bit more timid, especially in the beginning, but right now they're coming out early and they're playing aggressive, but they need to keep that aggressiveness when they are going up for rebounds, especially in the defensive end, because if you can keep it out of Coney's hands and not give them more opportunities after missed shots, that's going to be key. But the Warriors are doing a really good job of moving the ball around early in this game, finding the open man and giving them a good-looking shot. See Emily Mishoud right there, wide open, goes in for the mid-range two, goes off the inside of the rim. Just an unfortunate-looking shot there.
Just missed. Looked pretty good.
It did look good. And see, that exactly right there is what we were talking about. We made Coney pay for missing that easy layup right there. Reagan King going in for a mid-range two, and it fell, but Warriors got the offensive board. Addie Hawthorne going up for a tough two. Highly contested, and it does not fall. Reagan King coming away with another board, and she's going to slow it down a little bit. Try and set up a play, maybe. Goes up for a layup, but does not make it and gets fouled in the process, just so she will go to the line. And a timeout is called, so both teams will get a little bit of a break here, talk strategy. But 7 minutes, sorry, that's not right. That's not right. That's not the math there.
All right, let me chirp in here real quick.
Thank you, Mr. Brown, saving me from that math there.
No problem. Let's mention our first level Burgundy sponsors tonight. Casa Cattle, 249-2191. Clark's LLC, 368-4766. Camden National Bank, 368-4382. DT Lawn Care, 270-0342. And D.A. Gould & Grandsons Excavation, 938-2578. Thank you so much for being sponsors here at Nokomis Warrior Broadcasting.
Thank you, Mr. Brown, for speaking about our sponsors. We do love our sponsors over here at Nokomis Warrior Broadcasting.
We do. Thank you.
And I love listening to Mr. Brown over the mic. He just has that voice.
He has that announcing voice. Really, he does.
Reagan King draining the first foul shot, looking good early in this game. You know, we were talking about it earlier, but I think something that also just team. Elizabeth Parker there with the foul, and that's going to go into the Coney's hands. I actually don't remember what I was saying before that, so let's just talk about what's going to happen ahead of us in the game here.
Okay.
It's definitely been a Monday. Do you feel the same?
I feel like tomorrow's going to be a little more draining. Always back from the weekend, a little tired, but.
Yeah,
I feel the next day when I get back in the schedule.
Yeah. I also have a bad case of senioritis, so. A nice-looking move there by number 13, but her shot does not fall, and the Warriors come away with a rebound. Emberly Michoud, wide open three, and she punishes the Rams for not playing some tougher defense. I love the way this game is looking right now, and I think that our Warriors were totally right when I talked to them earlier about how they can really compete with anyone as long as they are staying positive and everyone is giving max effort. A beautiful looking three there by
Macy Freeman.
Thank you.
I gotcha.
We were ill prepared again tonight, not by the fault of Mr. Brown.
Not this time.
It wasn't his fault last time either.
We'll just blame him. He's easier to blame.
Yeah, you're right. Tough shot by Reagan King, and early on she is looking like a contender for, I don't know if it's Gilman or Bears player of the game today, but early on we're looking at a nice contender there from Reagan King.
Yeah, tonight we got the Bears one-stop player of the game.
Bears one-stop, good to know. Yeah, so we were given the wrong scorecards again. Teams are not updating their rosters on the KBAC website. So while we were down talking to the coaches, half the kids were graduated. And so I apologize for just saying numbers. That's probably annoying to the people listening, but I actually just do not have a sheet with the names. And so I have to look over on Hallie's sheet. And then I get confused and I don't know what's happening in the game.
We'll try to fix that at halftime only.
Yes.
And Freeman up with a shot and it's in for two.
So pretty high scoring game here in the first. Almost 20 points for each team. Reagan King, Emberly Michoud going in for another three, and it looked good off the hand, but does not fall. And so before the clock runs out, the Warriors are going to look forward to get the last possession and last shot up. See, that was an area really where the Warriors needed to get in, get a body on a girl, and get the rebound. Coach Kyle Peavy did just switch some starters in just put some subs in since the quarter is coming to an end, but it ended up being a Warriors ball anyway, so no issues there.
See the Warriors kind of draining the clock a little bit, trying to get that last good shot.
Absolutely. Emberly Michoud takes it, and it does not fall, so Coney is actually going to get the last shot here, but they got to be careful. and they do not get a point to end the quarter, which is good because you never want them to end the quarter on a point because it gives them the momentum.
And for the first quarter, Reagan King has 11 points. That's
wow.
Pretty awesome. And Emerald Mishi with 5.
Great start here by the Warriors. Great game. A lot of points scored in the first quarter here. Let's go to our mid-level white sponsors tonight. Sebastcook Valley Federal Credit Union, 368-4940. And in Pittsfield, 487-5576. A.E. Robinson and Corinna, 278-4626. Newport Entertainment Center, 368-2490. And Newport Glass, 368-5698. This is our mid-level white sponsors. Want to thank them very much for being sponsors here at Nokomis Warrior Broadcasting. And if you're interested in becoming a sponsor here, you can contact me here at the high school, Matt Brown, 368-4354.
All right, thank you. You know what? But I just realized, Mr. Brown, I realized that we are sponsored by two banks. I didn't realize that.
Yes. I think there's probably a couple more banks we can get in town, can't we?
Oh, there's got to be. If you're a bank listening in, you might as well add yourself to the list. Your contenders are on the air, so. All right, and so Coney's possession here to start the second quarter. And hopefully we're looking to see another good quarter of ball being played. And I don't know who that was. I apologize. But drains a three. And so Warriors looking to get a nice shot up. Addie Hawthorne gets fouled going up for the layup. And so she will go to the line.
So Nokomis Warriors, they did a really nice job in the first quarter. There's four quarters in this game, and they did an awesome job, fought in the first quarter, and won that. And we need to try to keep this intensity up the whole time and really win each quarter and eventually win the game.
No, absolutely. And so far, the Warriors are playing the best ball I've seen them play. And this is looking like a really good ball game so far. And, you know, Coney played the defending Class A state champs really tight. When they face Lawrence, and so that's another good thing for the Warriors. You know, they're playing a really solid team, and they're showing how good they really can be when they're playing good ball.
Yep.
So Coney goes up for a three, and it doesn't fall. Reagan King comes away with the board, and I'm not sure how many rebounds she has so far, but it's got to be three or four, which is a pretty nice amount, especially when it's on the defensive end and they get a chance at a play. So Coney's ball off of some pitter-patter off each player's feet. And so we will see them receive the possession here. Briley Boulier playing some awesome defense, almost coming away with a steal, and she gets the jump ball. And that was the intensity you were just talking about, Hal. Just really hard-working girls on the court right now who want to win this game. And they see that they have a chance to play some real awesome ball here.
Yep.
But Coney is responding, and so they don't want the Warriors to keep this intensity up, and so they're upping their game too and trying to put even more pressure on the Warriors on defense. So Addie Hawthorne goes up for a short-range layup there, and it does not fall. A three is airballed by Coney, but none of the Warriors players get in there. Emberly Mishud with the Cooper Flagg type block there. Just came out of nowhere.
Just came flying across that court. Woo! Blink and you miss it.
True statement. That is intensity if I'll see it. And, you know, she dealt with an injury early on this season, and it's her senior year. So for her to come back and still be playing this tough and want to help her team in any way she can is just really awesome. And you love to see that type of leadership on the court by one of your seniors.
Speaking of Cooper Flagg, I don't know he played. If most of you know, he played in Maine this past weekend. We had a chance to go down and watch him play. And what a treat that was. It's hard to believe that Cooper Flagg and Ace Flagg were here 2 years ago. To bring the boys our first state championship. Quite a joy to watch, and it was nice to see them again this past weekend.
Yeah, it certainly was. It just what amazing people and ball players they are. And to think that they were here 2 years ago is just really crazy. But it's awesome to see them thriving at Montverde. And it was great to be able to see them playing. I'm confused on what just happened. I definitely didn't think that the ball was actually in bounds yet.
So, Mia, I'm going to ask you a question real quick, quiz you.
Okay.
Did Coney have 15 points the first quarter or 14?
They had 14.
All right, thank you. Just going to clean up
is
my
the
points
point
here.
Score keeping actual track here. Let's see.
We're running through.
All right, so Emily Michoud goes up for a three there and does not fall. And Maddie Roundy, while going up for the rebound, fouls one of the Coney girls. And so we are looking at a Coney possession here. It's going to be really important for the Warriors to try and shut down this possession. Since the Rams are ahead by two right now, the Warriors need to get the possession back and really work to get another bucket. They're playing a zone defense right now, which isn't super effective on a Coney team like this because they're moving the ball around really fast, and it is wearing the Warriors out.
Yep.
And the Coney Rams look like they're playing strict man-to-man. Addie Hawthorne for a two, just inside the three-point line, and it falls. And Coach Kyle Peavy calls a timeout. And I love to see the energy from the Nokomis bench. They are just cheering on their teammates, and they are hoping for awesome, awesome stuff.
Yep.
Want to mention, not many people know this, guys, but our students here at Nokomis who are in our broadcasting classes mostly do the cam work, do the announcing, and I just want to say thank you to all our students here at Nokomis. Dedicate a lot of time to this. Tonight we have Mallory Smith and Jaden Hawkinson on camera, and of course the Hallie and Mia helping with the announcing. I just want to say we couldn't do it without the students here at Nokomis. I'm very happy to have them all.
Well, thank you, Mr. Brown. How lucky are we to go to a school that has such a great broadcasting program and wants their students to be as involved as Nokomis wants us to be involved. And, you know, I did a speech today for my senior project in front of the freshmen where I talked about getting involved in high school. And Mr. Brown may have been a little bit salty that I didn't bring up broadcasting, but you know what? I didn't even think about it because it's just become such a routine part of my life. And just, I mean, I've had it on every doorstep of high school, so I didn't even think about it. But thank you so much for this amazing opportunity you provided us with. I mean, me all 4 years, and Hallie will have it. I mean, she got it in eighth grade, too. So, I mean, just what an awesome experience we've had. And couldn't do it without you, Mr. Brown.
Right. It really is amazing, the opportunities that Nokomis has here. And just the atmosphere. It really is awesome. Walking in on 8 a.m. mornings and seeing Mr. Brown and Mr. Kelly nice and happy, smiling. Happy for us to be here and ready to teach us, for us to learn. That's really awesome.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, I come in on B-days. I have first period B-days broadcasting. And I don't think I've ever seen Mr. Kelly come in with a frown on his face. And Mr. Brown's always there to welcome us in, and we always have something to do. We're never bored in broadcasting,
right?
So the ball has gone up and down the court a few times here in the time that we were just chit-chatting, but no points were scored, and so we are looking at a Nokomis possession here.
You can hear some cheering from the Coney Rams bench, too. They're keeping their energy up. And
yes, absolutely. A nice-looking shot off the hands of Hawthorne, but the shot does not go. And Emberly Michoud getting in the way of a long pass there from the Rams. And I just love the energy that she's playing with tonight. She's leaving her all out on the court. And I remember in middle school, back when it was still Summer Sense Basketball, I remember Emberly playing basketball, and she's grown up a lot since then, and just I've loved to see her growth and how hard that she's playing this year. Rams going up for a three, and it does not fall. Warriors come away with a rebound. Reagan King back in the game, and she's bringing the ball up for the Warriors. Hopefully she can run a play and see. You know, she's really hot tonight. Her hands don't seem to be missing a lot. A wry pass from Riley Boulier, and the no one is found. And I think that was Kale Barajas getting called for a travel. And so the Warriors get the inbound with 3:27 to go in the second quarter. Danny Migliori bringing the ball up for the Warriors. She finds Addison Hawthorne.
Travel calls on her, and she did not like that call, throwing her hands up in the air. Not really understanding why.
I didn't like that call either. I thought it looked clean to me, but you know what? I am not going to play booth ref today.
I don't know about that, man. We'll see by the end of this game.
Yeah, I'm going to play it again. It's all right. What can you do? Danny coming away with a wry ball, passes it to Reagan King, and her shot does not fall. And, you know, both teams are playing really fast. You would think that there's only 10 seconds left on the clock and not almost 3 minutes. All right, and the Warriors come away with a rebound, and so they are going to bring the ball back up on their side of the court again, and they are down by three here. And so we're just going to look to see a nice shot put up. We're not going to force anything here is the intention, and it's going to be a nice-looking shot. Riley Boulier had a nice-looking shot there, but she didn't really have the confidence to take it, and so she finds Reagan King in the paint. And again, she had a nice-looking shot but didn't find it, and Addison Hawthorne with the turnover, and so we are looking at the Rams possession.
Right, she's definitely not being selfish with that ball.
You know, there's a... sorry, I don't know
glitch?
What just happened.
Hello?
Yep. Human glitch, what can you do? I think I'm worse than a computer at this point.
Right, like you said, it's a Monday.
Yes, so true. Mr. Brown said it was a Monday, too. So Coney moving the ball around again, and a nice-looking mid-range floater goes up, and the Warriors get the inbound play.
I don't know if you fans can see that, but that was pretty cool watching the cheerleaders not shying away with the ball, but picking it up and throwing it back in. I don't know. I just found that funny because, you know, stereotypical cheerleaders, the ball's coming at me. But no, they didn't shy right away. They took it. Okay. Funny to me.
Hey, if it makes you laugh, it makes you laugh. Reagan King going in for a nice-looking layup there, but it does not fall. All right, a three is shot, and it does not go. And the Warriors come away with the rebound. We've seen a lot of the Warriors getting the rebound since we talked about it in the first quarter. They're really getting their body on the ball, like we discussed.
Our Warriors, they really need to make good passes and keep good control of the ball. You can see wild passes getting tipped off by Coney, and they just need possession of the ball and be more careful with it.
Absolutely. Emily Michoud finding Addie Hawthorne open behind the three. And she puts up a tough shot there. We have a minute to go here in the second half. And the Rams shoot a three, goes off the rim, off the backboard, and out of bounds. And it will stay a Coney possession. So, Hallie, we have less than a minute to go in the half, and I think that this has been a great ball game to watch. What do you think?
I agree. It's been close. Both ends are really fighting, and I think we're going to have some good pep talks for halftime.
Absolutely. And, you know, Maddie Roundy just came into the game, and she just decided to play basketball this year because she knew that the numbers were down and they needed to play. They needed numbers. And she just wanted to help the team out any way that she could. And today she signed her letter of intent to play field hockey at UNE. And so it's just really awesome to see athletes who play other sports coming in, trying something new, and it's just super rewarding.
Yeah, it really is awesome seeing that. She's a great all-around athlete, and seeing her help out when we're in need, it's nice.
Yes, absolutely. So we have a turnover there, and a foul is called. And so it's going to be a Coney ball.
7.9 seconds left. Second.
The Warriors down 5, 24-19. And so Cassie LaCroix puts up a tough-looking three, highly contested there to end the half, and it does not go. And so we're going to head to halftime now. And I don't know if the cheerleaders are doing a routine or not. They look pretty short-staffed today, but if they are, we're going to show it. And we're also going to rep some more of our sponsors. And, you know, I'm really excited for the rest of this game. I think that it's been awesome to watch. Both sides highly competitive.
I guess the cheerleaders aren't going to do a routine right now, right? Are you seeing anything?
Nope, they just
looking
left.
For their mats.
Okay.
Well, no, I don't think they're looking for the mats. The mats are on that side.
Okay. We'll do a quick sponsor commercial. You guys can go on break for a few minutes, and we'll be right back in about 8 minutes.
Awesome.
Before we get back to the game, first, we'd like to take a moment to thank our sponsors of Nokomis Warrior Broadcasting. Camden National Bank, 79 Main Street in Newport, 207-368-4382. Casa Cattle, 151 Nokomis Road in Corinna, 207-249-2191. Clark's LLC, 607 Elm Street in Newport, 207-368-4766. DP Lawn Care, 158 Libby Hill Road in Newport, 207-270-0342. D.A. Gould & Grandsons Excavation, 557 Todd's Corner Road in St. Albans, 207-938-2578. Sebastogook Valley Federal Credit Union, 87 Moosehead Trail in Newport, 207-368-4940. Newport Glass, 162 Elm Street in Newport, 207-368-5698. A.E. Robinson of Corinna, 60 Newport Road in Corinna, 207-278-4626. Newport Entertainment Center, 26 Main Street in Newport, 207-368-2490. And our co-player of the game sponsors, Gilman Electrical Supply, 53 Main Street in Newport, 207-368-4306. And Bears One Stop, 80 Moosehead Trail in Newport, 207-368-2230. Once again, thank you to all of our sponsors from Nokomis Warrior Broadcasting and all of Warrior Nation.
quietly. Sorry, guys, if you heard me singing that. Really getting into the song here. Mr. Brown, I mean, next time you could give us a heads up before you turn on the mic.
Sorry. Welcome back, guys. 1 minute to go here. Do you guys have any quick stats you might want to run down the first half?
All right, so for the Coney team, I have Morgan Cunningham with 2 points, Macy Freeman with 8, Morgan Fickthorn with 11, and Cassie LaCroix with 3. And for Nokomis, I have Emberly Mishu with 5, Reagan King with 11, and Addison Hawthorne with 3.
Awesome.
And I pray both my fingers that that is the correct math.
You know, we triple-checked, so I think it is. I do think it is. I'm sad that Mr. Brown cut your singing short. I really liked that. Really gave me a giggle.
Okay, Mia.
All right. All right, and so it's Coney possession here coming into the third. And so you know, I'm pretty excited to see how the rest of this game plays out. If the Warriors want to have a chance at playoffs and get in that top 8, this is going to be a huge win for them, and they need to stay aggressive because Coney is third in heel points, and so that would be huge. Reagan King going up for a tough rebound, tough layup there, sorry, and she misses it but gets her own board, and then
That's
she goes in for a 3
shot.
And just absolutely drains it. Nothing except nothing you can do on that shot. Just beautiful looking. And the Warriors come away with a steal, playing super aggressive here coming off the half. Kyle Peavy, coach, probably getting them hyped up in Thorndike's. Oh, and an easy layup there for Briley Boulier. And so the Warriors are coming out hot here in the second half. And Coney has called a timeout.
Great start here by the Warriors. Real quick, let's go over our main sponsors here at Nokomis Warrior Broadcasting. Gilman Electrical Supply and Bears One Stop are our Player of the Game sponsors this year. Very happy to have them both on board. Gilman Electrical Supply in Newport, 368-4306. And Bears One Stop, 368-2230. Two places that have our stalwarts in the community have helped Nokomis along the way, and very happy to have them. Tonight we'll have our Bears One Stop Player of the Game. Looking forward to...
All right. Thank you very much, Mr. Brown. And so the Rams are bringing the ball up their side of the court. And so Warriors obviously in that zone. Reagan King coming away with a steal, and hopefully she puts the grace on this layup, and she does. Absolutely beautiful. Coach Kyle Peavy getting excited on the sideline, and I can't blame him at all.
Love to see it.
I do too. I love the intensity, and I love when the coach is also hyping up their team. And so Morgan Cunningham going for 3, and she drains it.
Both teams really coming in here, going aggressive, and they're doing good. Nokomis now up by 1, and they're going to try to keep that.
That's actually not correct. They're now up by 1.
Oh, I'm sorry.
It's okay. We're home, just so that you know.
Yes, thank you.
Yep.
Working on it.
All right, and so Rams moving the ball around a lot, but the Warriors are getting the hands in the passing lane, and Reagan King comes away with a defensive board, and so she will bring the ball up again for the Warriors. And it's very obvious to see that she wants this win, and I think the rest of the Warriors do too. Danny Migliori going in for a mid-range 2 there, and it doesn't fall, and the Coney Rams come away with the board, and so they're bringing it up their side of the court.
On my side, it looked real close. Thought it was in, and then it bounced right out.
I did too. Another rebound there from Reagan King, and she is just all over the court, the floor, the, oh, sorry. All over the court, floor, all of it. She's everywhere tonight. Woo! All right, glad to be done with that sentence.
Take a breather, grab a drink. Let's go. Come on.
Yeah, I guess so. And so the Rams, once again with the possession, since Reagan King passed it accidentally off the foot of Boulier into the out of bounds.
I'm pretty sure that was Migliori that she passed it off.
Well, it went off of someone's foot, so I do know that much. And a carry is called on Coney, and so Warriors get the ball. The ball. Thank you.
So we're kind of finishing our sentences here.
Denny Migliore was super contested there and looking to pass it out to Delaney Ranlett, and it does not go to Delaney Ranlett. It goes out of bounds, and so Coney is getting the ball again.
Might be going to our camera person over there. That's actually not there. Short staff tonight, I guess. Good. Out of bounds, but good hustle
yeah, I was
and
gonna
effort.
Say, either way, it's going the Nokomis way.
Good effort by Morgan Fickthorn.
All right, Hallie, I have to ask you a question.
All right.
Are you hearing an echo in the headset?
Yeah, a little bit.
Okay. I thought I was. Oh, there it goes. Okay. Mr. Brown had to fix it for us, but man, all I could hear was myself talking and.
Ugh.
After a while, that does get a little bit tiring. Reagan King gets fouled going up for a layup, and so she's going to the line.
She's gone 1 for 2 today with her foul shots. Let's see what she can put up here. First one is good.
Second one is not good, and the Rams do a good job of boxing out. And the Warriors get a hand on that board, but they don't come away with it. And so, jump ball called there. Lots of things happening very quickly here at once, and I'm trying to stay on track of all of it.
In this game, you can really see how Nokomis really needs to get the rebound. I mean, there's 4 Nokomis players in the paint there, and then the 1 Coney girl gets the rebound and passes it off. It doesn't go in, but we need to really, or the Nokomis Warriors really need to work on getting the ball, handling it, and taking care of it.
Yeah, absolutely, and it's going to be really important, especially on the defensive end, because giving teams second chances at missed shots are just always disastrous, basically. And there, Reagan King misses a shot. The Rams get the rebound. They miss a layup. No one can come away with the board, and so it gets tipped out of bounds, and it stays on the Coney side of the ball. All right, and so the Coney Rams score right off the inbound, so it's headed back Warrior side of the court. 29-29 game, and I mean, really, Hallie, it's been so awesome to watch. Danny Migliore trying to force a pass there, not taking enough time to look at all of the open men on the court, and so the Rams intercept it, and it goes their side of the court, but they miss a shot, and Reagan comes away with a rebound. And we're hearing some feedback from the fans.
Yeah.
They are not happy with the lack of the call there. Good-looking shot there by Migliore, but it doesn't fall. And the and one for Morgan Cunningham, who is also playing a pretty good game for the Rams. And so it's going to be important to see how this shot falls. You know, the Warriors have jumped right out of the gate, though, in the second half. They're winning this quarter 7-5, and it's really important considering they were down 5 at the half. You know, the Rams have come back a little bit. They're 2 ahead, but considering that the fact that they had more of a lead, oh, my God, just what a beautiful pass, like threading the needle there. I love seeing that type of teamwork and passing on the court.
Yes, King to Hawthorne was very nice.
Just beautiful. And a beautiful looking 3 there by Abby Morrill, and she just drains it.
Nothing but net out there.
Yeah, but we don't want that. We don't want that for them. I didn't say that on the air, Mr. Brown. Ooh. All right, Warriors inbound here.
I don't know if you guys watching at home can hear this, but we do not have happy fans out there.
Yeah, we're hearing a lot of feedback, and none of it's really nice. I think the MPA should institute a rule. Oh, and a nice pass there by Emily Mishu to Madeline Roundy, who scores and brings this game within one.
And Coney really just fires back.
I was just about to say, Abby Morrow responds quickly.
Response, that's the word I was looking for. And a travel on Addison Hawthorne, but tough call out there.
You know, what I was going to say is the MPA should institute a rule where fans who complain have to ref a quarter, but I don't know how well that would go. But, you know, just to see what it feels like to be yelled at like that.
Not good is the answer.
Exactly. All right, and so the Rams make a shot there. And so we are looking at a 38-33 game. The Warriors have to be more careful with the ball, take better looking shots, and play better defense. They're giving the Rams wide open shots. Emily Mishu going up for a tough layup there, and it doesn't fall. Morrow going up for a three, and it doesn't go. Awesome defense being played by the Warriors there to get the defensive board. And a timeout is called.
All right, great action here. Let's do our sponsors real quick again. These are our mid-level white sponsors, Sebasco Valley Federal Credit Union in Newport, 368-4940, and in Pittsfield, 487-5576, A.E. Robinson in Corunna, 278-4626, Newport Entertainment Center, 368-2490, and Newport Glass, 368-5698. Again, thank you very much for our sponsors. Always helps to have a bunch of sponsors during the year, and we've got some great ones.
Yes, we certainly do, Mr. Brown.
As the game moves on, I think Nokomis Warriors are really talking or thinking about playing tougher defense. I mean, defense wins games, and that's going to come down to the last quarter.
Nicely put there, Hal. Totally agree with you. All right, and so the Warriors are going to look to slow it down a little bit here. We got a minute 40 left to go in the third, and they're going to look to put up way better shots, cleaner passes, and cleaner all the way around. Addie Hawthorne with a three, and it's off the front of the rim, but Reagan King almost gets the rebound but tips it into the hands of a Ram, in which a number 21 scores a layup.
Morgan Vickthorne. She's been their main scorer here in this game, and she's doing very nicely.
The Warriors really need to get a bucket here to cut into this 7-point lead and gain some momentum back going into the fourth quarter.
Absolutely.
And this would be a huge win for the Warriors if they can come away with it. Danny Migliori with the three, and it goes off the rim. But it's going to stay on the Warrior side. We can hear Coach Peavy really communicating with his team. He wants this win just as bad as all the girls do. But you can see that the Warriors are getting tired. Oh, and Danny Migliori goes up for an easy bucket, but they got to play some tight defense here. Eyes on the ball. 21's moving fast, but Emily Mishu playing some good defense. A good screen put there. But the board comes away from Coney. And some great passing. And a foul called on Reagan King. And so I believe that 14 will go to the line.
And you can see just how upset Reagan King was with that call. And, I mean, tough call.
Yeah, and we see earlier in the game, Barajas went to the line for two, and she missed both of them. And like we were talking about, missed free throws always come back to bite. But I guess she learned her lesson from last time because she does not miss now.
No, she heard you, and she's like, oh, really? I'll show you.
Yeah, I guess she took that personally. Sometimes I wonder if they can hear us.
Maybe
I should speak a little quieter.
No, not possible. Mia Coot's quiet.
All right, and she airballs that one, and so that's going to be a violation and go to the Warrior way. And just a comment on that last statement you made. I just want to say that you're one to talk. Maybe you're not as loud as me on the air, but you're a little bit talkative too.
Okay.
All right.
All right. Okay. Leave it at that. Don't need to fight, especially not on the air. Come on now. Got my twin out here.
True. Somebody called us twins today. Don't remember who it was, though. All right. Anyway, back to the basketball game that we're supposed to be announcing here. And so Warriors, Addison Hawthorne was fouled. And so the Warriors got the sideline play. And so they're on their side of the court. And they're just looking to, I think, drain out the clock and get their shot. Hopefully a three-pointer to cut that deficit by even more.
Yeah. Nice use of vocab out here.
A wry pass there from Emberly Mishu. And so the Rams get it with 23 seconds. And they're definitely going to be looking to drain some time off the clock because they want the last shot and they want to make sure that Nokomis has zero momentum going into the fourth. But we're really starting to see the Warriors get tired. I mean, all these five girls, I mean, have played the majority of the game, and that's really tough. But, you know, Coach Kyle Peavy has kept them in really good shape. And so that concludes the third quarter. We are looking at a six-point game. The Warriors are still playing just amazing, and hopefully they can really bring that intensity back up after Coney won that quarter. And so we're really just going to look to see the Warriors bring up the intensity, hopefully rest up in the 15-second break they get, and come out with a fire and come out hoping to win.
I just want to say, girls, tomorrow we have our next home game. We play Mount Blue. The games have been changed. The times have been changed. So instead of 5 and 6:30 JV varsity, it's going to be 3:30 and 5 tomorrow because of the impending storm that we may be getting tomorrow night. So we are trying to – the game will still be on, but it will be at 3:30 and 5. And we'll be airing that live here on Nokomis Warrior Broadcasting. Just want to let everybody be aware of that.
Awesome. Thank you, Mr. Brown. Yeah, we're supposed to be getting a nasty storm. So hopefully everyone stays safe and we don't lose power for a couple days again because no one likes that very much.
No. Keep away.
How are you doing over there with points? You got it all figured out?
I got it perfect. Not to brag or anything, but it's all lining up here. All
right, well, that's good. Because I've been cheating off your paper this whole time. So, hey, it's not my job to keep the points, though. It's definitely yours.
That is my job.
It looks like there's a little bit of confusion on the court.
Okay, pin drop in there. Quiet. What's going on here?
Well, everyone's confused.
Including us, too.
Yeah. Some things aren't for us to know, I guess. And so the Rams are going to get this sideline play. And hopefully the Warriors can play some really tight D and come away with a steal here and bring it back to their side of the court. I do like how the Warriors are still playing a zone defense, but I do think that it can be problematic at times, especially since the Rams are so fast. And Morgan Cunningham going in for another three. She has a really nice-looking shot.
She's come out in the second half and has scored a total of 8 points, and compared to two last half, or the first half, she's kind of shining through here.
Yeah, absolutely.
Stepping up for her team.
They have a 9-point lead, the Rams do, and so we're hoping just to see the Warriors compete, come out with some real fire here, and just cut this deficit to bring them back within distance. Oh, great pass there by Reagan King to Addison Hawthorne, but Hawthorne goes too hard up on the backboard, and Abby Morrow goes in for an easy layup. It's really hard to defend breakaways like that because it's so easy to foul. And so Danny Migliori finds yes, thank you, who goes up for a two and doesn't make it, but Addie Hawthorne does. And so she brings it back within nine. Oh, my gosh. Morgan Cunningham with another three-pointer. They definitely have to play tighter defense on her.
Absolutely.
Great pass there by Emily Michaud to Addie Hawthorne. Addie Hawthorne
dribbles all around the rim but does not fall.
You just hate those. You just hate them. Warriors not playing tight enough there, and so the Rams have come away with a fast lead here. They are really breaking away and bringing this game further than we thought had anticipated for the fourth quarter.
Yeah, you can see our Warriors getting a little tired, not playing as tough defense, and it shows as Coney's getting more easy layups and shots in.
Yeah, absolutely.
It's always interesting to see girls. Nokomis not being very deep, and you can see sometimes when a team that we're playing has seven or eight girls who can come in and out all the time. It does get tiring, and you know you have to be in great shape. And our girls have gotten better at tough.
Yeah, absolutely, and it really is. But we've seen a lot of growth from these Warriors. Early on in the season, we saw them get tired much quicker than they get tired now, and they're playing much harder all throughout the game than they were at the beginning of the season.
Yes, definitely.
Emily Michaud shooting a three, and it goes off the rim, but Briley Brolier with a rebound. She passes to Addie Hawthorne, who doesn't make the shot, and so the Rams get the rebound there. Reagan King playing great defense.
And a foul is called. Two shots. First shot is good for Abby Morrow.
Her second shot falls as well.
Had a good shot there.
Addie Hawthorne and Reagan King having some passes between them, but Reagan King unfortunately has the ball slip out of her hands, and so that pass goes awry. And so hopefully Reagan King can take this time to slow the ball down and look for a good shot. And the Rams are called for a holding foul, so it's going to be an inbound play for the Warriors.
We've seen them in their inbound plays working very nicely and getting some nice buckets out of their good passes.
Yeah, absolutely. And they're really going to need one now. We're looking at an 18-point lead here. Reagan King going in for a three-pointer. It's off the front of the rim, but she gets her own rebound, and that's why you follow your shot. But she passes it over to Briley Bullier, but it gets intercepted by Abby Morrell, who then goes up for a layup, gets her own rebound and scores the second shot. And so now it is a 20-point game. Coach Kyle Peavy calling the timeout. And, you know, coming into this game, I think that a lot of people weren't expecting the Warriors to play it as close as they were. And, you know, it was really refreshing and awesome to see them play as tight as they were and as aggressive as they were. And I think that they're just a little bit worn out right now, and they're giving Coney too many opportunities, second chances.
Yep, they just need to try to keep up, keep the intensity, and see how it works. Keep their heads up, that attitude.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, there's only so much intensity one can bring when they play almost all the minutes. But I think that the Warriors are doing a really good job so far, especially with a team that's third in heel points compared to the Warriors' ninth place. But we knew that this was a rebuilding year and first year with a new head coach. And I'm just super proud of our girls for all the growth that they've made. And hopefully they can bring this game back within at least 10.
Yes, very well said.
But they have to be cleaner with the ball and make better passes in order to do that. And then Cassie LaCroix going in for an easy mid-range too.
And you can see the Coney Rams aren't really missing their shots here.
No, definitely not. But Reagan King goes in for a two there. That brings it back to 20 instead of 22. But a wide open three there. It's off the backboard, but the Rams get the rebound, so they put it back up.
I know we've said it a million times here in this game, but really rebounding is a huge part of this game.
Absolutely.
And that's what the Warriors need to work on here.
Delaney Ranlick going up for a three there. Does not fall. It goes off the front of the rim. And the Warriors do get the board on that one. Emberly Mishute coming up the floor. She forces up a shot there instead of looking for an open man, and so Coney gets the rebound. So Danny Migliori fouls there, and so the Rams are going to take it on the sideline. All right, Hal, I have to ask a random question here. If you played basketball, would you wear, like, the knee pads or, like, one of the sleeves or the leg sleeves or an arm sleeve or something?
Honestly, I'm not sure. I mean, it's kind of like a drip sort of thing. That's what the kids call it nowadays. More style. No, I probably wouldn't. I wouldn't get down on the ground. Not aggressive
I think I would.
Enough.
You would? I think I would wear.
Just for the style factor, or
yeah,
would you get down there?
No, I'd be diving all over the place, I think.
You want that ball.
Absolutely. So I think I'd wear two leg sleeves like Cassie LaCroix.
Hmm.
So the Warriors are moving the ball around quite a bit, just trying to find, taking more time with their shots, trying to find a good one. Danny Migliori going up for three, and it goes. So a big shot there, bringing it back within 20. And hopefully the Warriors can slow down the Rams, and actually the Rams slow down the Rams by calling a timeout.
And we wait.
You girls thinking about Nokomis' player of the game tonight?
Yes, we are.
Okay. We won't declare it yet, but see if you girls are leaning one way or the other.
Yes, I certainly think I am, and I think that you will agree with us.
And behind the scenes in the booth here, Mia Kutz over here, she stole my pencil and drew me a heart. Just such a nice thing to do, isn't it?
Who said I drew it for you? It's not just for my paper.
Oh. Okay. Well, just assumed, you know?
You
look over at me when you're drawing a heart, but I'll take it.
Sometimes you just got to doodle. Sometimes there's just dead silence and you're doodling. All right, and so the Rams moving the ball around outside the perimeter here. Holding foul called on the Warriors, so the Rams will take it on the sideline again. And 2.5 minutes to go. It's looking like the Warriors are not going to be able to come back from this deficit, but they played a really awesome game, and if they can even just bring it in within a few more points and show how tough they really are, that'd be awesome. And we can see Matty Roundy playing with quite a bit of fire even still left in this game.
Yes, she puts the pressure on the D, and she does a very nice job, especially coming back in, as you said.
But it looks like the Warriors are playing really good defense right here, trying to be a little bit strong with the ball as I bite my tongue and the Coney Rams score a layup.
Too soon.
I know. Reagan King going up for a three, and it is off the backboard, so that's not going to go the Warriors' way. And the Rams putting up a shot, and it was Cassie LaCroix, but Reagan King comes away with the board. Danny Migliori shooting for three and drains it. And so a timeout is called. Some subs are going to come in, and this is an 18-point game.
Yeah, we've seen a lot of three-pointer shots this game, and actually a lot made. We can see the percentage pretty high.
Yeah, absolutely. And, you know, it's just been a really team effort on both teams within passing the ball and taking shots. We're seeing each team having a little bit of diversity and just making sure that each individual player is getting a chance.
Sorry, I couldn't help you out there.
It's hard to believe, girls. We're halfway through the season.
It really is hard to believe, Mr.
Yeah.
Brown. Did they play 18 games?
18 regular season games. Yes, they do.
Wow, that's a lot. We play 16 regular season games for softball. And I know field hockey plays only 14 regular season games. Hmm. How many does football play? Eight?
Eight regular season games, yeah.
But, of course, that's a little bit different.
Comparison, a little different, yeah.
That's a little bit different. They only get one a week.
And you can see the Warriors have put their subs in and all their starters on the bench.
Same thing for the Warriors. I mean, the Rams. Sorry.
Wake up here. Come on. Minute 18 left.
It's actually my bedtime. It's 7:48. I'm usually in bed right now. Like I said, I have senioritis. Really hit me hard.
So it's all right if I called you old now. I mean, you're yawning in this booth.
Well, I suppose. What can you do?
And that's banked in by
Elizabeth Parker.
Elizabeth Parker, thank you.
Annie Nice getting on the floor there. All right, and so Delaney Randlett bringing the ball up with 30 seconds to go, and she... softball throws it to Annie, but it does not reach Annie, and it goes out of bounds. So the Rams will probably drown out this possession just to, you know, get the last shot, I suppose, even though they're up by however much. And so, Hallie, let's talk about our player of the game tonight, our Bears one-stop player of the game. You know, this one player for the Warriors really played her absolute hardest, scored the majority of the points for the Warriors. Had a bunch of boards as well. And so tonight's Bears one-stop player of the game is going to be Reagan King.
Yes, she did a really awesome job. She played good defense. She drove in, made a lot of shots, and she really showed that she wanted to win this game, and she did her best.
Yes, absolutely. All right, and... sometimes in basketball, we find that the last minute and a half is actually like 5 minutes, and it's the longest part of the game. Do you feel that way, Mr. Brown?
Yeah, sometimes the last few minutes, if you get a bunch of fouls, it tends to drag out a little bit, but it looks like this will be it.
All right. Thank you all for tuning in to tonight's broadcast of the Lady Nokomis Warriors versus the Coney Rams. And just an awesome game of basketball to watch. And the Warriors do lose to the three-seeded Coney Rams, but it was, like I said, an awesome game to watch, and we are really looking forward to more of these Warriors games and watching them grow even more. And make sure you tune in for tomorrow to watch the Lady Warriors play Mount Blue. They are looking to come away with a win in that game. And so thank you all very much for tuning in to another round of the sister duo announcing here tonight.
Yes, thanks very much, girls. Any public performance, rebroadcast, reproduction, distribution, unauthorized retransmission, or other use of this program is strictly prohibited without the express written consent of Nokomis Warrior Broadcasting or RSU 19, all rights reserved, 2024.